It's hard to imagine, but Lawrence Hill was stuck in a writing rut on a different project when a new novel came bursting through. And to get himself unstuck, he switched gears and started writing for an entirely different audience. He's writing for children. Inspired by bedtime stories that he would tell his daughter, Hill is now publishing his first children's novel, and he's joining us this morning. Good to see you.
Good morning, Anne-Marie.
Congratulations. The new novel is called Beatrice and Croc Harry. Take us back to the genesis of this project. I understand you were writing a different book. You were a little bit stuck. You were also navigating through some serious loss and grief in your personal life.
Yes, my mother had died, actually, and I helped her. She had asked me to assist her in an assisted death in Switzerland, and I was still grieving the loss of my mother, and I was having trouble finding my way in a new novel, and so I just looked for something that I could create, something joyous, something to soothe me, something fun, and I found this story that I'd been working on by telling my daughter stories when she came into my life when she was three. My youngest of five, Beatrice Friedman is her name, and I would tell her stories every night about a girl with her name, Beatrice, who every night would fight off a crocodile who would attempt to have her for breakfast, lunch, or dinner, and she'd always outfox a crocodile at the last minute and survive to live another day. And Beatrice loved these stories about her own character, named after her, and made me promise that one day I'd turn it into a novel. And here we are, 15 years later. Beatrice is now 22 years old, but the novel's finally baked.
Oh, okay. What does Beatrice think of the fact that you know, fulfilled your promise? This is actually a book.
She's delighted. She really is. Of course, I wouldn't have done it without her blessing, but she's tickled pink that finally the story has come out. And I've dedicated, in one way or another, all of my books to the five children, and she's the youngest, so it's her turn. So it's about time, she's telling me, that a book is finally written in her honor.
Let's tell people about this story. So Beatrice wakes up in a forest. She doesn't know who she is or where she is. There, you know, a lot of times in children's literature, there's sort of an adult level and a child level. What is this book saying overall about identity?
Well, it's an allegory about the aftershocks of the transatlantic slave trade, in which, you know, millions of people were hauled across the ocean and completely divorced from their any ability to know anything about their past, even their names. And so that's not mentioned in the book, but that's really the principle on which the book is operating. Beatrice wakes up alone in a massive forest. She has no idea who she is. She doesn't even know that she's black. And she's there are no human beings. The forest is too large to escape. She has food. She's in a treehouse. She has books. But she has nothing else, no other humans. And she's got to find out why she's been excommunicated from the human race and how she could make it back, and she can never figure out who her family is and where they might be.
There's a real playfulness with the language here. Beatrice has only a few things with her in this treehouse, one of which is a dictionary. So talk to us about the language in this book.
Well, there's a St. Lawrence dictionary of only the best words, real and concocted, in the book. And of course, I learned all sorts of silly, playful terms from my African-American father, who came with my mother to Toronto the day after they married interracially in the early 50s in the States. And, you know, goozlum and willy lump lump and all sorts of silly words were tossed around our kitchen table. And I love these playful nonsense words. And so I incorporated a bunch of them, you know, into the book, as well as a lot of highfalutin, exaggerated words in the English language that is kind of fun to make fun of. And so Beatrice encounters a 700-pound, always hungry crocodile named Harry, who has sort of packs a PhD vocabulary, and she's always being stumped by these big words that the crocodile is throwing out at her in the midst of trying to have her for breakfast. And so, you know, there's a lot of language play in the book, and I did that, well, because I love the play of language, and I did as a child, but also because it's a serious story about serious issues, about the loss and reconstruction of identity. So I needed to let in lots of humor and shafts of light so a child and an adult, hopefully, would find it entertaining, even though, you know, it's a difficult story.
Okay, Lawrence, I'm listening to you talk about this book. I'm very intrigued, but I also want to know, when you were reading and telling these stories to Beatrice when she was young, just three, did you have a voice for any of them?
Well, yeah, I had Croc Harry's voice for
sure. What does it sound like?
Beatrice, it's time to palaver. Please come out for our 11th season palaver with me. Please, Beatrice, come a little closer because I just wish to tell you a story about my moral rectitude. And so he would attempt to draw her close with this soothing, you know, fast-talking, hyperverbal voice. And, of course, as soon as she got close enough, snap, you know, he tried to have her for a meal. So they were dueling from the start of their relationship. And then, of course, they have to overcome this will he or won't he eat her for breakfast thing and form a testy friendship and go on a journey. And he's going to be enlisted. This natural predator is going to be turned into an ally, and he's going to help her discover her lost identity.
Lawrence, I love your writing. I cannot wait to dive into this one, and I cannot wait to find a young child to read it to. Voices and all. The book is called Beatrice and Croc Harry. Great to see you today.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate the chat. I hope you enjoy the book.
I can't wait to read it. All right, don't go in.
Hey, thanks for watching. If you liked this, be sure to subscribe here, or you can check out more Your Morning videos right here.